seems like it's more of a change management issue than anything else. You know, how is this tool or solution being marketed throughout the organization? How is it being talked about? How is it being promoted by key senior leaders who have influence within the organization? How are people talking about it just informally amongst their own network? So it's a communication issue, seems to me, which is part of change management.
So when I think, Joe, when you first started sharing and you were talking about how you had about a, I think it was a 33% adoption, I was thinking in my head, you know, that's actually pretty good. Like, I think sometimes we wish that when we launch something, we have like 100% adoption in the first 6 months, or we're seeing that kind of usage. And when you're shifting from learning being perceived as training in the classroom or as an event to now you're offering something that's maybe you still have the formal components, but you're also offering those assets in the moment of need, whether it's through an app or as Sarah's been sharing on the chat through, you know, push text messaging, and, you know, maybe it's much more mobile than in the past. Well, that's something pretty new. And it is a change management piece, and it's not a change that people will instantly adopt. And so I think a lot of what we're talking about, what really strikes me from that is that we have to be prepared for the long game. It's a long game you're going for, not the short transition. And in that long game, it's every bit of communication is a point of learning. So driving awareness could be a learning goal in itself, even though we might normally call that learning goal marketing. It's, you know, just raising awareness that this exists is learning for your community or your organization. So thinking about what learning assets are going to help them grow awareness is great as well.
I was just saying that I think the biggest challenge is, even though, you know, sometimes the directives you get from leadership is 100%, you know, they always have these high goals and you're always trying to adjust what these percentages look like and how does increment look before you move on to the next thing. Understanding your audience so you can have that conversation is huge. Knowing what data you have to support that, though, is also huge. A lot of us are in situations where we don't have the data to talk to leadership to say, here's a realistic SMART goal to get to that point. So we're churning and churning and churning and trying to create, but we really don't have the numbers to say, here's what we know is a real number we can strive to. So I would also say that helping them realize that we have this goal, but we have had this increase in this area, looking at how to tie that into the business is big, huge factors for the groups that we work with.